Hi, this is Tim in eLearning. Today we're going to talk about how to add captions to your new recordings in Panopto. This is a great way to help make your videos more searchable and help make your course content more accessible to your students. First, I'm going to locate the video I want to choose out of my Panopto folder. I'm going to do this video here called Upload Video to Panopto. So as I hover over the video, you can see I have different settings that show up here, and I'm going to click Edit to move into the editor. Inside the editor, I come over to the Captions tab, click Captions, and from the dropdown, we have two options, either to import automatic captions or to upload or request captions. Today we're going to look at the automatic import feature. This is a feature where the Panopto software listens to the recording and does its best to figure out what the recording is saying and automatically add the captions itself. If you have specific modifications or need professional captions to be added, contact eLearning department to do that. Don't use this link here. So I'm going to click on the Import Automatic Captions link. Here we can see the automatic captions have been added in. And if I want to, I can listen to the video and also come in and modify the captions. So basically clean them up. So here's my first sentence. Hey Mark, I wanted to take a few minutes here just to show you how to upload your finished video into Panopto. You'll notice that Panopto has a hard time figuring out the word Panopto. Your finished video independent audio is not correct, so I'm going to come in here and say into Panopto. So it's really easy to start with these automatic captions and then come in and clean them up or modify them as you need to. Once you're done with that, you can come over here where the CC button is. You can choose different settings, but it's important that you make sure to turn this on. If you don't turn this on, even though you've taken all the time to add the captions won't show up for your students. So make sure, you can see in this case, the button is blue. If I click it again, it turns gray and now the captions are not there. So I want to make sure I turn on the captions and close the caption tool. When I'm done, I've imported the automatic captions. I've taken some time to go through them and clean them up to make sure they're correct. And I've turned on the captions down here. Then I need to be sure to go up and click the publish button to lock in any changes and republish the video. Hey Mark, I wanted to take a few minutes here just to show you how to upload your finished video. So now I have the captions embedded. I have the correct word of Panopto down here, and I can see the captions are turned on by default. This is a great way to help make your videos more accessible, not just to students with disabilities, but to all learners. It's a great practice to get into your default workflow, so I encourage you to do it. When you make a new recording, come in, turn on the auto captions at the very minimum. This also helps make your videos more searchable. If your students want to search through the videos to find a place where you talked about a certain item, the captions will allow them to search that and find those locations. If you have any questions, contact us at eLearning and we'll set up an appointment. Thanks.